Okay, I think I have everything set up. Okay, my mic should be working. I hope so. Oh, okay, cool. It's working. Yeah, no, it's just, it's a very, very pretty game, Sean. You're gonna like it a lot. Oh, God. Sorry, I really should have done this earlier. Oh, there we go. Also, if anyone ever ends up getting the game, this is well worth putting on for your second playthrough. It's pretty insightful. Alrighty, here we go. I have got my ice cream, I have got my chat, and I'm ready to go. It's this one. Way more chill than before, but don't let the view deceive you. This game will break you.
I can make it there. I hope. Please let me make it there.
Swirling vortex of terror, we deal with that every day.
Whoa! That was so surreal.
Previously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay, I'm in class. Everything's cool.
Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller?
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Ugh.
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by-
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
By the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly, it's bullshit.
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century. But I like it old school.
Capture you in a moment of desperation. And any one of you could do that to me. Isn't that too easy? Too obvious?
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
That you were a 18-year-old girl with an angsty diary?
What if Arbus chose to capture people at the height of their beauty or innocence? She had a brilliant eye, so she could have taken another approach.
I have to admit, I'm not a big fan.
Shh, shh, shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius. You can find out all about him in your textbook, or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Even her school books are gift-wrapped. I can't believe she made fun of me in class. What is she, 15 years old? And people laughed. I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell.
Jefferson, I just worked so hard in the shop, and I'm sure you know what it's like to be consumed by your work.
Now I wish I wouldn't have read this. Purge.
I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important...
Hi, Kate.
Oh. Hi, Max.
You have just by participating.
You seem quiet today.
Just thinking too much.
This is just a bump on a bigger road. I don't want any...
I hear that. Want to go grab a cup of tea and bitch about life?
Thanks, but not today. I have to go over homework.
No worries. Let's hang later.
Sure.
This might make a cool shot. Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me.
Because she probably is. Everyone knows a Victoria.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
I'm not paying a
hundred.
Welcome to the real world.
Just cute?
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture.
Because Max wants everybody to see how hip she is.
He plays it so
sharp. I need a serious timeout in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
She's so fucking shy. She takes selfies with a giant camera.
Evan doesn't say much to me, but his photos are very cool. Alyssa is always texting, but she doesn't hang out with a lot of people.
American girls, it's sad to imagine.
I love that picture of mom and dad. Hello, Jack. Kiss, kiss. Andy, you look totally fabulous, as usual.
Be part of the world around you.
That's Dana talking to, I think his name is Justin. Dana is on my floor too. She's such an archetypal, gorgeous cheerleader. They must make them in a factory. I shouldn't be so catty. Dana is nice to me. I've seen Brooke hanging out with Warren. She seems like his type.
To all of you,
poor Daniel, he's so nice. I wish I could beat the shit out of Logan.
No one can tell where your heart is.
It looks like she's been gone for months.
American girls like dollies, with shiny smiles and plastic buddies. I wish I had.
Empty. Good. Nobody can see my meltdown. Except for me. Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it. When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down.
Don't ever. Sick of people trying to control me.
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho.
No.
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now, shit! Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Capture the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy, anybody? I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane. Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why are.
I did it.
Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human time condition machine in black and white? Anybody? Bueller?
Max, don't freak out.
Arvis.
Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arvis? Because
when I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
What you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
course,
this.
As you all know, the
it's
photo
real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation.
So I can go back in time.
For selfie expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
can I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography. For
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits.
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not gonna get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me after class. And I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind again and give him the right answer?
Now, Max.
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of Evan. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Yes, Victoria, you still have to do your homework. I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I'd never let one of photographers...
I'm not avoiding, just...
Biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you.
Wait, do I actually have to do this? Normally I do this as a joke.
Yes, Victoria, you still...
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes. Because, like, you can rewind time and get the right answer.
Excuse us.
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers. Good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
It's like, normally I do that as a joke, but I was like, oh, you know what? No, let's just, like, go back to the bathrooms. But now it's like, no, shit. The game actually makes you do it because I couldn't turn around.
Please, please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy.
You know I don't tease.
I hate that science class with those nerds.
What's that got to do with anything?
Which way was?
This is because if you send me a picture,
there we go.
Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick!
I need a hammer to break it open!
Control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
I need a hammer to... Holy shit, I can't let this happen! If I can reverse time, I need a hammer to break it open.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone, and please turn off that alarm since that's your job. You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
I think I'm gonna hide the truth this time. Normally I report him. Just for funsies, but... Nah, why not?
I just got sick in class. Female trouble.
Except you're wandering around like a zombie. And do you think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
It's the truth. I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson's
class.
Just
tell me what you're hiding. You can trust me.
There's nothing to hide. I got sick. It happens, you know.
There's that teen toot again. You know, I've heard enough. Don't think I don't know what goes on around here. You've only been here for 3 weeks, and you're already causing conflict. I don't think your parents will approve when they find out. Now get outside with class. Please.
No, he does not buy that at all. I may have just flushed my scholarship down the toilet.
Nah.
Yes, I could rewind and actually tell him the truth.
You've got plot armor, you're fine.
Rachel Amber. She looks so hopeful and pretty. I wonder what happened to her. Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
Poor sweet Warren. He's not as dangerous as Elliot, but he's still a little bit bit of an incel. Just a little. Wait, shit, where do I actually go?
Hi, Brooke.
Let me guess. You wanna fly my drone?
I'd love to. I love planes and balloons and...
This is neither. Do you know what a drone really is?
A weapon, right?
You read too many conspiracy sites. This might be too complicated for you. Funny. Warren said you were smart. Please, step back.
Because I'm feeling petty?
What a complicated name for such a tiny drone.
You're damn right I'm gonna abuse and exploit my power.
Sorry, Max. I have to focus on making sure this drone doesn't crash.
Hi, Brooke.
Let me get...
That looks like a high-fly drone. Model B400 EVO. Now, that's a nice piece of tech.
You're full of surprises. Why would you know that?
I love aerial photography. Drones are perfect for that, especially those with great range. It's a new era of images.
Most impressive, Max. Warren said you were multifaceted. Here, give the drone a whirl around campus.
Fucking crash it. Oh, that reminds me, I gotta sign this teacher's petition. Just to ruin David's day.
Hi.
Hi, Miss Grant.
Excuse me, Max. I know everybody loves being asked to sign a petition, but would you do Miss Grant a favor and hear me out?
No.
Sure, I always have time for you. What's the petition?
David Mattson, our chief of security, wants to put surveillance cameras all around the campus. Halls, classrooms, gym, dorm rooms, etc. Blackwell Academy should be a high school, not a high security penitentiary.
David Mattson doesn't need another excuse to harass students here.
Max, this isn't about personalities. This is about protecting civil rights and our school's legacy of freedom. Blackwell Academy has a noble heritage, from the Native Americans who founded this land to the pioneers who shared it in peace, not fear and violence.
It's like, yeah, every Blackwell student should be free to bring any firearm they want into school. I'm sorry, I thought this was America.
Blackwell is that old? That's incredible.
You should learn a little history about your alma mater. You'll find some fascinating facts. There's a lot of power in this region.
No shit.
I think it helps the creative juices flow around here. Now, before I assign you homework with this lecture, will you please sign the petition to keep our campus from going back to 1984?
Huh.
Absolutely. I don't mind security, but not pure surveillance.
I knew you were my favorite new student at Blackwell for a good reason.
Did not mean to press the button. You're gonna see a lot of that. I'm not even gonna lie. Heck, I might sneeze and rewind time by accident.
What's up, Daniel?
Oh, hi, Max. Could I, ask you a question? Would you mind letting me sketch you?
I do put my sketches on Facebook, though.
I'd be honored, Daniel. Makes me feel like a muse.
Funny you should say that. I was just thinking about my real muse. Rachel Amber.
Hard to avoid her posters all over campus.
Kills me to see her sweet face used as a crime photo. She had a good heart.
You knew her?
No, but once she asked me to draw her portrait. Oh, she was a natural.
So what happened to her? There's gotta be a story.
She just stopped coming to class. Some people said she ran away. Some say she jumped off a cliff. I just hope she's okay.
Okay. Why don't you start drawing me? Even though I must be a step down from Rachel.
No way. You're a good substitute, Muse.
Sub something.
Oh, that's a good posture. Good. Good.
Sketches and ink before pencil. We got ourselves a badass.
Best portrait ever.
Sorry. Hey, Stoner Justin, we didn't get
Yo,
to talk
Justin,
much in the last game.
Check
but...
out the Max. Come to Thrash?
Oh yeah? Bring it.
What's your first move gonna be?
Jump?
You're such a poser. If you can't even name a simple nose slide or a tray flip, you should walk on.
Okay, asshole. Just for the record, if I had this power, this is all I'd do all day. Screw the whole, like, superhero act. I just use it to be right.
Yo, Justin.
Check out the Max.
I came to nose slide. But I'd love to see somebody do a tree flip.
Oh, sick. You're not a poser.
Nah. I just can't skate worth shit.
Aw, oh, check it. We're gonna destroy some rails for you. What do you want to see?
Okay. I think if I get him to do a tray flip, he hurts himself and I can take a picture of it.
Go for a tree flip.
Let's get Trevor all over that action.
Oh, ow. Ooh.
Can I? Yes! Poor Trevor. Best part? Now, you know what, Trevor, buddy, I'm gonna save you your dignity here. Because I'm gonna rewind it so it never happened. You're okay. Everything's okay. You know what, I'm gonna do one better. I'm gonna get you to nose slide because I don't think you get yourself hurt
Yo,
doing
Justin,
that one. So, I'm gonna make you look like a badass.
I'd love to see a nose slide.
Let's get Trevor all over that action.
You! See? See, Trevor? You scratch my back, I get the photo for the collection, and now you... Look at you over there, folding your arms. You know what you did. You know you look fucking cool. Alright. Oh shit, wrong way. Have to go to the dorms first. I'm pretty sure that's this way. It's been a while. Fuck you, Evan. Not even talking to Evan. Evan can fuck off.
Come on, Logan, bring it, bro. Yeah!
Yeah, you throw that football. Fucking football, bro.
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
Oh, look, it's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled. Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. Right, we ain't moving.
I could just, like, walk around you.
Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way.
It's like, what I don't understand, Max, is like, you're a grown woman. There is plenty of space
to just,
like...
Do you understand English?
Walk around.
Get lost.
I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way.
Nice, bro.
Oh, she ain't talking. That's fine. She needs space. I dig.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Oh my god. That is like the worst problem. No.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Okay. scheming.
Okay, Victoria?
Oh, Samuel, sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo!
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I dry.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches. Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
Fuck it.
Don't say a word, Max.
Oh, wait. Hold that pose. And no filter needed before I post this. Now, please move. I've had a messed up day, and I'm going to my room.
You do that? I know where you live. So does Nathan.
Maybe I shouldn't have done that.
Nah, it's fine.
Hurry, Courtney!
Good luck.
Victoria is going to be pissed if it took so long. Home sweet home, my favorite cocoon. The Max Caulfield Photo Memorial Wall.
Mother.
principal sent an email saying he's concerned about your attitude and behavior, that you were not fitting in well and hiding in your dorm. I know it's hard to be away from home, even if you are all grown up now, but you are there to change the world with your camera. Please call me as soon. Call me soon to chat, yada yada.
Mommy.
Ah, yes. Buy your daughter's love.
I look so pathetic. Daniel has so much talent. I hope nobody hates on it just because it's me. I am so addicted to this site. Look at these vintage beauties. Warren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here.
Okay. Here's our mission for the entirety of the game. This plant's gonna live, okay?
You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama.
Now,
drink up.
In the next episode, I need to not water the plant.
One day I'll organize my film collection. One day I'll get an actual HDTV. Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note. Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell.
Time to insert myself into drama.
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
You are ridiculous.
She's your friend.
Friends don't sex with their best friend's boyfriend.
No, probably not. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk, just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet Watson. Duh.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
It just means that
according
I played
to Victoria,
the game before.
Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything. But I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
Okay.
Answer you.
That's real nice, Victoria. And who the hell thinks I'm a hipster? Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
Oh wait, shit, where's her printer? Oh, duh, on the fucking desk.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
Now, is there anything here that I can steal, perhaps? No? No, okay.
Juliet, read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk. Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Must protect my precious, so Max never has to chase it down again.
I better make sure everything is still in there. I think Warren forgot to hide the Party Buster folder. Not that I would open it, no matter how tempting. I have my self-respect. Of course a popular cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends. It's so fascinating to get a peek into Dana's social media world. And yes, Max, so terribly wrong. Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Victoria is not nice. I don't get it. She has everything. And to pull that prank on a friend?
Just because they're in the Vortex Club doesn't mean they're BFFs. I'm in it, and Victoria creeps me out. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
He's a good guy. A geek like me.
You saw the files in his flash drive. Tons of crazy shit. Films I've never even heard of. And in a special folder called Max.
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
At least I can confirm Warren isn't a serial killer. He is, however, an annoying Dexter. A very annoying Dexter. I'm pretty sure this isn't the exit. Or is it? No. Good God, it's Resident Evil all over again. Haha.
Fuck this shit.
Damn, I better rewind.
Fuck this shit. Fuck this shit. This shit. This shit. This shit. This shit.
Okay.
I feel like Alyssa and I should be better friends.
Ow! That hurt!
Ouch, poor Alyssa. That'll leave a bruise.
Okay, one more.
Fuck this shit.
Okay.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
Yeah, but like I did also watch her get like hit maybe 12 times before I did that, so you know, there's that.
Max, that was awesome. Thank you.
No problem. You have quick reflexes.
Years of mad dodging skills. Bullies never change.
That's why you're better off.
You're smart. We should hang out more. Now I have to finish this stupid book.
Okay, I'm gonna level with you. I don't like you as a person, but that was hilarious.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
Well, now I hope you burn in hell.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're
not. You know, being a bully.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate.
Now I gotta go do the rest of my job. Being
I felt like an everyday
too.
Hero helping Kate, but...
Yeah, I feel good about that interaction. Bullying little blonde girls and their friends. USA, USA, USA.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
How could Zack and Victoria do that to me?
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zack yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He always wants my attention, sweetie.
Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Yo, Max, check it out. What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
Man, I saw that Victoria didn't take down that pic of you on Facebook. Major bitch move.
See, the thing I don't get about it is the photo she posted was actually kind of nice. It's like, oh yeah, yeah, Max looks pathetic. I was kind of like, but it's kind of an okay photo. I don't know.
No worries, Warren. I took a sweet shot of Victoria I can't wait to share.
Oh, score one for Team Max. It would be so karmic to see her ass clown face all over the interwebs.
I guess she does deserve it for all the shitty things she's done to people here.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw?
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white, plus babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
At least he's self-aware to some degree. Like, I won't interrupt the conversation, I'm just gonna...
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
for reals, Warren. This is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw, now. Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore
right
in the bathroom!
Yep, there's the license plate I mentioned.
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody!
We're not gonna try to run. We're gonna drive, man.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
No, it felt like a real city for artists. Big and bright. Great for taking pictures.
Yeah. Must be hard coming back to a hick town like Arcadia again.
Not after seeing you.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course. It's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max. Haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific, tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. Come on in. Don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home. My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers. She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
And now I want fairy lights. Fuck it, I might actually get some of those during the week. That'd be fun.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
Totally just a friend.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot, even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
I see why. I bet your mom was not too happy.
She was happy enough to marry a Nazi. Reason number 356 to escape.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Yeah, where's the stereo? I was literally only looking at it a minute ago. Oh, yeah. Duh. Observation skills. Non-existent.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Nope. Someone locked it from the other side. 15 kids in the backyard. I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. I should be able to find the tools I need here. Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them.
Actually, you know what? There's something I'm gonna do. I wanna see if there's something that I can find early on, because you come back to this location later, and I just wanna see if there's something that I can find beforehand.
What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this?
Cover my tracks.
That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? Remember that stain? Chloe and I knocked over Joyce's wine bottle and we scrubbed forever, but it never came out. We got so busted.
It's so weird considering the limitations of the game at this point in time, because like in this one, upstairs and downstairs are separated, but I think when we were playing before the storm, you can just walk downstairs. Like, that's kind of, I don't know, it's kind of weird to think about.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera. So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Booyah, you skank. Karma's a bitch. Nice framing, too.
Wait, I've seen this before.
No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat?
In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life.
Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
Not at all. Your hair and clothes are so different.
I hope so. I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
I wanted to. What if he goes on some rampage?
Nathan fronts like a thug, but he's a spoiled punk-ass biatch.
He would have shot you, Chloe. That's a fact. I should tell the principal.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
Seriously, I didn't blab to anybody. Promise.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that phony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera. Song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Oh,
don't
shit.
Get smart. Just let me.
Wrong
Chloe,
wasn't.
You're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Oh, I know. I just
get
hit the
smart.
Lamp.
Just let me in now, please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this door.
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control.
Wait, is that grass? You been token up again in here?
Oh, yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order. Whose is it?
Stop treating me and my mom like we're your family platoon.
Hey, leave Joyce out of this.
I wish you'd leave Joyce, like now!
Chloe, I'm sorry. I care about your mother, and you just keep pushing me.
Don't touch me again, asshole. That's the last time. Or I'll bring the cops in here so fast!
You're not that dumb.
I'd be smart to have you busted.
Chloe, someday you'll grow up.
Hey, you okay?
Welcome to the real step-douches of Arcadia Bay.
I'm sorry.
For what? He would have been a bigger dick if he caught you in here.
That's hard to believe. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can go to in this hick hole.
David was such a mean bastard to Chloe. What if I had stepped up to help?
Okay. I'm just gonna point out, the reason I chose to stay hidden is because I feel like a lot of people kind of, they say, oh yeah, no, David is completely justified in, you know, his attitude because he has PTSD from, you know, shit where he's fought or whatever, just, you know, overall just kind of like trying to justify his bullshit, really. And, like, that particular choice. I mean, first of all, it's not one that I really explore very often when I play this. And, I do kind of want to see how that pans out after, you know, Chloe kind of finds out that you can rewind time and stuff. Because I honestly don't know what the hell happens. I normally, like, once I see this, I tend to rewind and change it. But I think I'm actually gonna leave it be just to see what happens. I'll change it in the, remaster. But yeah, it's like a lot of people kind of say, oh yeah, no, it's just his PTSD, and I'm just like, he struck the person he calls his child, so no, he's an asshole.
We'll go out through the window. Seeing Step Dick is not on the agenda.
Sean, I don't dance like that purely on the grounds that I don't dance at all. I avoid it at all costs, actually. No one should be subject to that. Ever. A pretty game. It's like, I know it's getting a remaster and it does desperately need one in a lot of ways, but the game is just always... Oh, sorry.
So why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa. This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today.
But yeah, like, despite that, despite, like, it needing a lot of tweaks, at least I think, visually speaking, it still holds up, fuck's sake, Warren. It's like, okay, here's another thing. Warren, he's not an Elliot, because Elliot was actually dangerous. Like, the thing that I don't like about Warren is that Max has kind of just made it clear she's not interested. You know, but I don't know, it's just, he's just super persistent, and, like, I'm kind of getting secondhand cringe, because I've also kind of been that person, too, and I'm just like, buddy, come on, like, it gets better, move on, but at the same time, it's also... Through it all, like, he still does kind of want to be Max's friend, even if he's thinking of something else, you know? So, like, he's not a horrible person the way your man Elliot was, because he's actually dangerous. Like, Elliot followed Chloe all the way to, like, Rachel's house. Like, he's an actual stalker and had a meltdown. I mean, I know a lot of people are saying that it's kind of extreme to get him expelled over the whole thing, because, you know, cops had to be called and stuff, but, like, no, that behavior would only have escalated. Like, let's say he moves on from Chloe and he stops writing really, you know, serial killery poetry about her. It's only till he moves on to the next person, you know? Whereas at least Warren, it's kind of like he'll eventually get the picture, but he's also just kind of being the wrong kind of persistent about it, too. I don't know. there's something just a little bit off, you know? He's got some growing up to do. Like he's like.
Earth is so lucky.
He's an 18-year-old.
He can always escape.
Ooh, can I take a picture of that? Hang on. Sorry, I'm playing this with one hand.
Man, I should have helped Chloe. I feel so bad.
Honestly, same, but...
How long has that been here?
For the story.
Clearly, the Bigfoots are everywhere.
Return to Monkey. I can't get a photo of this.
Sure you don't want to be alone?
Sit down if you want.
I'm sorry I wussed out.
No worries. I know my step dork can be scary.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. She's cool. Only that prick would bully her.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
I wish. You know I would have read them.
I'd love to. They must be important, or he wouldn't hide them deep in his garage bunker.
He kinda creeps me out. I bet the truth is out there in his files.
Most likely, but it's good you didn't find his files. He would go ballistic. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
I knew you didn't know. Chloe, your house is under surveillance.
What are you talking about?
There are cameras all over the house. I saw it on a monitor in the garage.
I knew it! He's so hella fucking paranoid! I'll keep this a secret for now.
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
Even yours?
Not anymore.
So what do you have on Nathan?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
How much do you owe?
$3,000 plus interest. And before I could get a chunk of that from Nathan, he dosed my drink with some shit.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
I am so furious, I can't even speak. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Good thing you didn't tell anyone. Nathan Prescott better watch his back now.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved.
Like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass. Straight for the town. Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh my lord, this is real. It's real. Oh man, this sucks.
Max, what's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years. You just zoned.
No, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But high, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max?
Because of climate change.
Start from the beginning. Tell me everything.
Through the blizzard.
Okay, that was episode one. Yeah, like I said, it's a lot more laid back than the other game, and as you can see, the episodes are a little shorter. They kind of vary. It kind of also depends on how you play them as well. Like, there are certain things that can kind of drag an episode out just a little bit. But yeah. Still holds up. Like, I haven't actually played this game in a while. Like, I've watched plenty of playthroughs over the past, you know, couple of years, but I only really play this, you know, once every so often. And I was, like I said, I was supposed to kind of play it for Halloween last year. But, I don't know, I think I ended up playing Resident Evil instead. One of them, anyways. Because, like, this one is supposed to be set in October. It's, like, in the lead-up to Halloween, so I thought it was kind of fitting, but, like I said, True Colors is going to be coming out in a couple of days, so I wanted to sort of do a, recap, I guess. I just won't be playing Life is Strange 2 because I'm not ready. My heart is broken. Still healing. So, there's that. It's still kind of early, so I might... early for me anyways. I think I'm gonna do episode 2. I'm going to take a 15-minute break, and might make some herbal tea, and come back. So yeah, give me like 10 minutes. 10 minutes tops. If it takes longer than 10 minutes, the internet has shit itself, and in that case, you know, wait 10 more. So yeah, I am coming back, and I am going to do another stream. Just to give you a heads up, I'll be closing this stream, as always, to set up the next one. So it'll be open in a different window. Do not sit on this one, because, like I said, it's going to be in a different window. You'll be staring into blank space. Alrighty, talk to you in a bit.